Hello, this is Matt Gibbons from Maid to Glimmer, where we want every house to glimmer.
It leaves streak marks and smear marks. I mean, you pick it up, it drips everywhere, it's heavy, it smells like a dead rat, which is why most people would rather use a trusty sponge mop. Sponge mops, fantastic for waxing your floor. But if you use this as a floor mop, again, all it's gonna do is push the mess backwards and forwards, and you end up doing what Callie used to do. She used to shove the mess underneath the refrigerator when no one was looking. You push down on the handle. This is my favorite part right here. It sandwiches that dirt right back into the sponge, so you're always mopping your floor with a dirty, disgusting sponge. Not very nice. Now, there is one other mop out there. This is your dust mop. Now, we've all seen this in the store. Great invention, because you've got to keep going back to the store and buying the pads. I mean, you mop one average size floor, these pads get filthy. It's just like wrapping dollar bills around your mop.
It and is. The thing is, they're with this expensive. Mop,
it's only good for dusting. You can't even use it for wet mess like this, okay? Now, if you're using these mops right now, you're spending over $100 a year on mops that don't work, okay? So do yourself a favor and watch this spin mop demonstration. You may have seen it before, but this will change the way you think about mopping.
Which is why we love your calls, because you're going to laugh at us being all excited about this mop until you hear other people who have it too. Original, keep in mind. And I love it. I spent more on it. The original, this one's better and better price.
I mean, look at this. Okay, you put the mop in one side of the bucket. Okay, this is your washer side. When you push down on the foot pedal right there, it spins the mop inside the bucket. You then take the mop on the other side, which is the basket side. This is your dryer side. Again, you push down on your foot pedal. Now, the faster you go, the drier the mop's going to get, okay? So it uses just centrifugal force, which makes good sense. Your mop comes out nice and clean. Now, I don't know if we can get a big overhead shot of how nasty this kitchen floor is, because right here, I'm gonna clean this whole entire mess without rinsing this mop. Now, the nice thing is, this mop is actually made from microfiber, okay? That means it leaves no streaks or smears on any surface, even if you have hardwood floors or pergo floors. Mm-hmm. Look at
Which
this. It's got a 360-degree swivel head that allows you to get right up to the corners of your kitchen, against your sideboards. You know what's a nightmare, Callie, is behind the toilet bowl. No more on your hands and knees with your face down the toilet trying to clean behind your toilet bowl. The spin mop gets into all those difficult to reach spots. Now, it also lays down so flat, look, that you can easily mop underneath a bed, underneath a refrigerator.
That's a good point, because this gets dry as well as wet.
Exactly. Dry for dusting, wet for mopping. Now we're going to clean up this big, disgusting mess. Now, this mop absorbs about 10 times its own weight in liquid. It's just like Tony Little down the pub. It's like a thirsty camel in the Sahara Desert. Look at this, it picks up that whole entire spill in seconds. Now we're gonna go over here and finish cleaning the floor. Now you may notice that no streaks or smears whatsoever. That means you don't have to put a towel underneath your feet. Now you'll be surprised at how many people are still putting a towel underneath their feet to dry their floor. It's called what I call the funky chicken dance, like this.
That's scary.
I know.
I mean, honestly, we laugh about it, but if you've ever had that experience, it's like, if you have, oh, you don't want to slip and fall. Anybody, and that's the thing, you don't have to like clear the house for an hour or two, because it doesn't leave any water behind. That microfiber cleaning cloth, which by the way, you can wash a couple hundred times, so it's one investment. You don't have to replace that head. We do have extra heads if you want them as backups, or you know, as a secondary in the meantime. But watch this, because you just saw Michael pick up that entire, this whole floor was filled with water and gross, black, icky, disgusting water. And look, it's holding
I know, and listen, it's now sparkling clean. There's your mess. Now, the nice thing is, your hands will never, ever, ever touch this dirty mop head ever again, okay? To get this clean,
exactly. This
is my favorite part. All you do, look, is you pop it into the bucket. Now, remember, you do get the mop, you do get the bucket.
Yeah.
This is a complete cleaning system.
Good point.
Keep the mop vertical. You then just simply push that on the foot pedal. It's now spinning and winning all that dirt right out of the mop, right into the bucket where it belongs. I mean, it's just absolute genius. You then take the mop out, you place it on the other side. This is your dryer side. Again, one side to wash it, one side to dry it.
Like a salad spinner.
Just like a salad spinner, exactly. And the faster you go, the drier the mop's going to get. And look at that. I don't know if you remember how dirty that mop was.
Check it out.
Look how clean it is.
And again, now you're going back at the floor with a clean mop.
EasyVid presents the 10 best spin mops. Let's get started with the list. But has a patented spinning system. You might have seen this one before. It's popular on the QVC network. In the number two slot, it's the Mopnado Deluxe Rolling Spin Mop. Now for number one. The Cyclomop Commercial Spin Mop is a professional grade mop for the biggest, dirtiest jobs. It comes with a heavy duty bucket cleaning system on dolly wheels. It features a dual action handle and a foot pedal operated ring system.